The last step in completing your friend is making the jacket. So you'll cut out the pattern, and it is a one-piece pattern that includes both the front and the back of the jacket, and you're just going to sew it all as one piece. And then you're going to choose your fabrics, and I've chosen two quilting cottons here, and you're just going to iron them, place them right sides together. And then all you do is mark with whatever your marker, your fabric marker is, just right on the line. You trace all the way around. So you're going to stitch right on the line, and I have a little jacket that I've completed here. So if you look closely, you can see that I've just used blue Sharpie here and then stitched right on the line with red thread. So you stitch all the way around, and then at the bottom you see we have these slits, what you're going to cut as slits, and that makes the openings in the sides so that the jacket can move easily on the doll. And you don't sew at the tops of the arms, or I guess those would be the little shoulder areas. And then all you have to do once you've done all the stitching on the line, is just trim it out with about a quarter of an inch of seam allowance all the way around. And then up at the top where it's curved, I use a quarter of an inch here usually. You can go a little bit less than that, or you can do the quarter of an inch and then snip in a couple of little, let me move this out of the way. You can snip in a couple of areas to help the curves look good when you turn it right side out. And then on the inside, this is the armhole, what you want to do is cut relatively close to the stitching, so about an eighth of an inch here. You can try, if you feel confident, you can try clipping down at the bottom of the armhole, but it usually isn't necessary. So down at the bottom, you will have traced the edge of the slit, and then you just sew right on that line. And then what you're going to do is you're going to trim, and you want to get right up to the corners of that little rectangle. So to do that, you get yourself a pair of very sharp scissors, and you just trim right up to about a quarter of an inch away, and then you go in as close as you can to the stitching to leave a little triangle of fabric that looks something like that. And what that does is it allows this slit to open up all the way into a complete line, which it won't do when the jacket is on, but you need to have that to be able to have the piece of clothing look normal when it's on the doll. So once you have everything trimmed and cut out, then you turn it right side out through one of the shoulders. And it doesn't matter which one you pick. You can just kind of stuff something in here and just kind of pull it through, and it's going to take a minute because you're pulling the entire garment through this one shoulder, and I'm not going to show that. So it's going to look crazy, and it's going to be ugly, and it's all going to be wrinkled. And what you want to do then is press everything really nicely and neatly so that everything is flat, and you want to press it so that the two sides don't show from the other side, so like the inside doesn't show from the outside and the outside doesn't show from the inside. Now the jacket can be reversible. In this case over here, I used two different prints, so I could reverse the little coat if I wanted to. This case, I just used something on the outside and then something plain as the lining. So then what you're gonna do, well, I'm gonna go back to this one here. Pretend that this is turned right side out. So to complete the jacket, you're just going to turn this under a quarter of an inch. Ah, dang it, it's not working. So you're just going to turn those shoulder areas inside a quarter of an inch, and then you butt the two together, and then you just use some inconspicuous stitch to sew along the outside of the garment and the inside of the garment. You do it on both shoulders, and then you have your little jacket complete. So at this point, you can embellish it if you want. You can do embroidery, you can add beads, you can do all kinds of things. And I have a whole bunch of videos devoted to that, so I decided not to cover it in this case. So when you're done, you're gonna have a cute little friend that has a custom-made jacket, and you will have made your very own art doll. Congratulations.